Hello, welcome to part 2 of product animation. So guys, in this tutorial you will learn how to add some water droplets by using geometry nodes in a very simple method and how to make it realistic Fanta can like that. First of all, I switch to shading tape and I will add some material to it, and I will increase my metallic value to 1 and decrease roughness to like that, and switch my mode from solid to material. And here you can see we have made it metallic like this. Now I switch in solid mode again and I will add some texture to it to make second slot where I will add my image texture. So for that I switch to in face selection by pressing 3, and now guys you can see I will select faces where my image to be applied. So I have selected the part where I want to apply my image texture, and now I will give it a second material and assign it, and now I will add a image texture to it. So I'll select principal piece tape and press Ctrl T, and now you can see we have 3 nodes: texture coordinate, mapping and image texture. So guys, if you press Ctrl T and you only create image texture and you didn't create both nodes, then you have to enable node wrangler add-ons. So for that you can go in edit preferences, and here you can search node wrangler and you have to enable it. Now I'll again switch to material preview, and here I will just apply my image. So for that I have downloaded one Fanta PNG image, and now guys you can see here this my texture is not perfectly aligned to this can. So for that we have to unwrap perfectly for applying this image texture perfectly. So for that I will go in UV editing, and from here you can see face selection. Already I am in face selection mode, so I'll go in select. So for that, before going in that, I will just tell you one thing: we have to unwrap this model. So for that, selected these faces, I have to mark some boundary loops and I will add some seams to it so that it can easily be unwrapped. So for that I will go in select loops, select boundary loops, and here guys you can see some boundary loops are selected. One is on top of that can and one is bottom of that can, like that, of that faces. And by pressing shift I will add, go in edge mode, you can see, and I will select. This one, and this one. Now I will add themes. So just click on UV, and here you can select marks in to these edges. Now guys you can see here some red marks highlighted. So now I will unwrap this model. So you just select all by pressing A and press U, unwrap angle based, and now it's unwrapped like that. And I have selected this option island, and here you can see this is the top of our button, this is the bottom, you can see this is the bottom, yeah, this is the top, this is the top, and this is the this part, yeah, this part. Okay, so this part is, we have unripped, we have added some seams to this one. So for that I will just align this. Okay, so these I don't need because I have applied a metallic value to these ones, so I'll just drag it down from my image texture so it won't apply. And now for adding some material to this perfectly, I will just select this and rotate it like this, like this, and we see what happened with the scale in x-axis, sx, gx, sy, yeah, gy. So guys, you can see this is happening right now, but this is not okay, still not okay. Yeah, applied but not okay. You can see here, yeah, you can see this is not straight. So for that we have to straight the faces, and for that you have to enable one add-on, that is UV square. Yeah, okay, and now I've just pressed N, and you can see here UV square, and we have to straight these faces. So I'll now press N, the N panel, and UV square, and to create shape. Okay guys, to create by shape. So now you can see we have perfectly straight the faces, and now I will apply to GY A6 like this, and here you can see our problem is resolved now. Yeah, or something like this. We have to further again analysis in SY. Yeah. Perfectly aligned, and this texture is looking much straight. So you see here, you can see. SX to cover this part also, so that it will be visible here. And now GX, and move it slightly to left. And now guys, you can see we have perfectly applied the texture, applied the Fenta can image, Fenta label. Yeah, okay, so now we will add some droplet to this. So for that I will use geometry node, and first of all for adding this we will add by procedural. Okay, so I will tell you step by step how to add water droplets to this our Fenta can. So first of all, you have to click on at new, create a new modifier, geometry node. Yeah, you have seen here geometry nodes modifier already created, and now here you can see two options, group input and group out. Here first of all we have to convert these faces into points. So I'll select distribution points on faces. Okay, and I'll, yeah, and now further, now you can see here guys, from our can now some points are distributed, and now I will add another point to volume. I will convert into volume, so point to volume. Yeah, further I will just convert this volume to mesh. So I will search volume to mesh, now you can see here something like this. And now guys, we have to reduce the radius value to 0.04 like this. And now I will make it smooth, so I will another search here, shade smooth. Guys, geometry nodes are very useful. You can use it, and here you can see the effect shade smooth here. Now guys, further if you want to again reduce the value, if you want to reduce the size of your water droplets, okay, and now from here I will just want to add some more control. Yeah, so for that I'll choose the amount option, and here I'll add some voxel amount to add some extra meshes. So I'll just go to 250, and same here also 250. Okay, and now guys you can see, and now I will just take my Fanta can also. So for that I will just click here and search here join geometry. Yeah, join geometry, and join geometry, put it here. Yeah, now guys you can see our Fanta can came, and you can see now. So for this I will add some randomness. So for that I will search randomness, random value node, and just give it output to radius. Okay, and here you have two options, minimum and maximum. So I will just add 0.03 and 0.01. You can see, yeah, 0.02, okay, 0.01. Okay, and here you can have more control, so choose from random to Gaussian disk, and now you have to increase the density. Yeah, you can see, but guys here you can see water droplets are connected to each other like that, so we have to save this value. Yeah, and also reduce the density like this. Yeah, now these are not connected. Yeah, some randomness you can see here. Okay, now we have to give some texture to it. So for that I will just add here set material, and we have to need material first. Go in setting tab, and from here I'll choose one more new and give the name to water 3. Okay, and now I'll reduce the roughness and increase the transmission to 1 to make it more transparent like water. And now go in your just geometry node, and from here you just choose that material name, that is water 3. So this is water 3, and now guys you can see something happened here. Yeah, you can see here water droplets have been made, created, and like that you can also create. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial. If you have any problem, then you can ask me. You can leave your doubt in comment box. I will reply whenever I will be available. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial.